Hello students, with this lecture we are going to start chapter 9, strategies for enhancement in food production. In this chapter we are going to study main topics like animal husbandry, plant breeding, single cell proteins and tissue culture. With ever increasing population of the world, enhancement of food production is a major necessity. Biological principles as applied to animal husbandry and plant breeding have a major role in our efforts to increase food production. Several new techniques like embryo transfer technology and tissue culture techniques are going to play a vital role in this further enhancing of food production. Let's start with animal husbandry. Animal husbandry is the agricultural practice of breeding and raising of livestock. As such, it is a vital skill for farmers and is as much science as it is art. This animal husbandry actually it deals with the care and breeding of livestock. It's like animals, buffaloes, cows, pigs, horses, cattle, sheep, camels, goats and some other animals which are useful to humans. It also includes poultry farming and fisheries. If we talk about these fisheries, it include rearing, catching, selling with some purposes of fisheries, as well as some shellfishes, mollusca and crustaceans. Animals like prawns and crabs, they are also a part of this fisheries. Here they estimated that more than 70% of the world livestock population live in India and China. So this way, this type of breeding and raising livestock of certain animals, they are useful to mankind, and these all are included under animal husbandry. Management of farms and farm animals. It's a professional approach to what have been traditional practices of farm management, which gives the much needed boost to our food production. So, this type of management is actually include procedures employed in various animal farm system. First of all, let's discuss about dairy farm management. The dairy farm management of animals for milk and its products for human consumption is very useful. This dairy farming management is actually built with processes and systems that increase yield and improve quality of milk. Milk yield is primarily depend on the quality of breeds in the farm. So, selection of good breeds having high yielding potential is must here. Some other aspects of dairy farming or dairy management, that is selection of good breeds having high yielding potential, so it can give large production. It's combined with resistance to disease is very important. So the variety of this animal actually when it is healthy at that time, it is very useful for production in dairy management. Another thing, that is cattle, they have to be house fed, should have proper water and be maintained disease free. So this way, this dairy farm management under this certain condition, these animals they are provided healthy condition, so they may remain disease free. Next one is feeding. Feeding of cattle should be carried out in a scientific manner. It's like quality and quantity of fodder. It means that the food they are taking, this type of cattle, so actually having good quality of food, all component of food should be maintained under this food. as well as quantity of food also. Next one is strict cleanliness and hygiene. Their importance while milking, storage and transport of the milk and its product. So this step of dairy management is actually required for good production under this condition, and properly it can be carried out by farmers. Second is poultry farm management. Poultry farm is actually a class of domesticated fowl or birds used for food or for their eggs. So it is important here. They typically include chicken and ducks and sometimes turkey and geese also. The word poultry is actually often used to refer to the meat of only these birds. But in a more general form, if we talk, it may refer to the meat of other birds too. So these all are included under poultry farm management. Some aspects of this poultry farm management, they are important here. First, selection of disease-free and suitable breeds. It is must because the healthy breed, they can give large production. Second, proper and safe farm condition. Third one is proper feed and water. When this type of condition is provided, then it is useful for economically purpose also. Hygiene and health care, it is also essential condition under poultry farm management. So this type of poultry farm management is also useful for humankind as well as economically also. Now let's talk about animal breeding. Breeding of animal is important aspect of animal husbandry. Animal breeding aims at increasing the yield of animals and improving the desirable quality of the produce. So this is main aspect of animal breeding, that increasing yield of animals and improving the desirable quality of the product. If you talk about particular the word breed, is a group of animals related by descent and similar in most characters. It is like general appearance, features, size, configuration and some other types. So the breed word is important here. If we talk about types of breeding, there are mainly two types of this type of breeding. First, inbreeding, and second, that is outbreeding. Inbreeding, this term refers to the mating of more closely related individual within the same breeded for 4 to 6 generation. And outbreeding, that is crosses between different breeds. So this is main difference between inbreeding and outbreeding. Inbreeding is breeding between animals of same breeds, but outbreeding is crosses between different breeds. Let's compare both inbreeding and outbreeding. First, inbreeding is a mating of closely related individuals within the same breed for 4 to 6 generation. So we can say they are of same group and within 4 to 6 generation. Outbreeding, it's a breeding the unrelated animals of the same or different breed not having common ancestor. So this is main difference between inbreeding and outbreeding. Inbreeding, common ancestors are there, but in outbreeding, it's not having common ancestor. If we talk about further types of inbreeding, inbreeding is not further classified into any type. Outbreeding, it includes further types like outcrossing, crossbreeding and interspecific hybridization. Now, as we know very well, inbreeding is a mating between same species, but outbreeding is a mating can be between different species also. So, these are main point of comparison between inbreeding and outbreeding. Now let's compare outcrossing and crossbreeding. Outcrossing is the practice of mating of animals within the same breed but having no common ancestor on either side of their pedigree up to 4 to 6 generation. Crossbreeding, it refers to the mating of superior male of one breed with the superior female of another breed. That is important here. In outbreeding, so mating of animal within the same breed but no common ancestor in pedigree up to 4 to 6 generation. But crossbreeding here is actually term related with mating of superior male of one breed with the superior female of another breed. Outcrossing, in this a single outcross helps to overcome inbreeding depression. In crossbreeding, it is done to combine the desirable quality of the two breeds into one individual. That is difference between outcrossing and crossbreeding. If we talk about advantage of outcrossing, here it is the best breeding method for animal that are below average in productivity and growth rate. That is important here. Advantage of crossbreeding, here the hybrid progeny may be directly used for commercial production. So both are having advantage of their types. So this way we can compare both method, outcrossing and crossbreeding. Now what's inbreeding depression? This term is important here. If this way the continued inbreeding process mechanism take place, it reduce fertility and even productivity of this animal, and it is harmful. Whenever this become a problem, selected animal of the breeding population should be mated with unrelated superior animal of the same breed. So one can overcome this problem by taking this mechanism. It is like selected animal of the breeding population should be mated with unrelated superior animal of the same breed. Usually it helps restore fertility and yield. So this way, by continuing breeding process, inbreeding process, it may reduce the fertility and even productivity in animals. Outbreeding. Outbreeding is actually breeding of unrelated animals. As you know now very well, what is the difference between outbreeding and inbreeding? So, outbreeding is the breeding of the unrelated animal, which may be between individual of the same breed but having no common ancestor. This term is important here. No common ancestor for 4 to 6 generation. Here is a in between different breed, crossbreeding or different species. It means interspecific hybridization also. Outcrossing. Outcrossing is the practice of mating of animal within the same breed but having no common ancestor on either side of their pedigree up to 4 to 6 generation. Offspring of such a mating is known as outcross. It is the best breeding method for animal that are below average in productivity, in milk production, growth rate, and in beef cattle. A single outcross often helps to overcome inbreeding depression. So this way outcrossing is very important. crossbreeding. In this manner, superior male of one breed are mated with superior female of another breed. Crossbreeding here, it allows the desirable quality of two different breeds to be combined. The progeny hybrid animals may themselves be used for commercial production. Alternatively, they may be subjected to some form of inbreeding and selection to develop new stable breeds that may be superior to the existing breed. Many new animals breed, they have been developed by this approach. Hissardel is a new breed of sheep. It's developed in Punjab by crossing Bikaneri Hills and Merino Rams. One more term that is important here, that is interspecific hybridization. In this method, male and female animals of two different related species, male and female animal of two different related species are mated. In some cases, the progeny may combine desirable features of both the parents and may be of considerable economical value. The most important example here, that is example of animal mule. This way, controlled breeding experiments are carried out also by using artificial insemination. Here, the semen is collected from the male that is chosen as a parent and injected into the reproductive tract of the selected female by the breeder. The semen may be used immediately or can be frozen and used at a later date. It can also be transported in a frozen form to where the female is housed. In this way, desirable matings are carried. Artificial insemination helps us overcome several problems of normal mating. So this way, interspecific hybridization method, this an artificial insemination, is also very useful in animal breeding. Multiple ovulation embryo transfer technology. In short, it is also known as MOET. Often the success rate of crossing mature male and female animal is fairly low even though artificial insemination is carried out. To improve chances of successful production of hybrids or other means, they are also used, and one of this is MOET here. MOET program for head development, it is useful for improvement. In this method, a cow is administered hormones with FSH like activity. Now you know very well about the hormone FSH, we have already studied, to induce follicular maturation and super ovulation. It means that instead of one egg, which they normally yield per cycle, they produce 6 to 8 eggs, that is super ovulation. More than one egg production is there. The animal is either mated with a light bull or artificially inseminated. These fertilized eggs at 8 to 32 cell stage are recovered non-surgically and transferred to surrogate mothers. The genetic mother is available for another round of super ovulation. This technology has been demonstrated for cattle, sheep, rabbits, buffaloes, mares, and some other animals. High milk yielding breeds of females and high quality as a lean meat with less lipid meat yielding bulls have been bred successfully to increase head size in a short time. So this way, This technology is very useful in animal breeding technology. Beekeeping. It is also known as apiculture. This beekeeping or apiculture is the maintenance of hives of honeybees for the production of honey. It has been an age-old cottage industry. Honey is a food of high nutritive value and also finds use in the indigenous system of medicine also. Honeybee also produce bee wax, which finds many uses in industries such as in the preparation of cosmetics and polishes of various kinds. The increased demand of honey has led to large scales of beekeeping practice. It has become an established income generating industry, whether practiced on a small or on a large scale. This beekeeping can be practiced in any area where there are sufficient bee pastures of some wild shrubs, fruit orchards, and cultivated crops. There are several species of honeybees which can be reared. Of this, the most common species is Apis indica. It is most commonly used for beekeeping purpose. Beehives can be kept in one's courtyard also, on the veranda of the house, or even on the roof. Beekeeping is not labor intensive. So this way is economically also very useful. Beekeeping, though relatively easy, does require some specialized knowledge, and there are several organizations that teach beekeeping also. Some points that are important here for successful beekeeping. So one can manage this beekeeping apiculture his own way, and economically it is very beneficial. First, knowledge of the nature and habits of bees. For beekeeping or apiculture method, this point is very important. Second, selection of suitable location for keeping the beehives. When location is proper, so suitable for this of beehives, at that time large production is also achieved. Next is hatching and hiving of swarms. It's actually group of bees. Then management of beehives during different seasons. It is also important for their production, that management of this beehives in different season. Next one is handling and collection of honey and of bee wax. Bees are the pollinator of many of our crop species that we have already studied in chapter 2. It is such like plants, sunflower, brassica, apple, and pear. Keeping beehives in crop fields during flowering period increases pollination efficiency and improves the yield beneficial both from the point of view of crop yield and honey yield. So this comparatively in animal breeding method, this beekeeping or apiculture method is very easy to apply and economically very useful method. Fisheries. Fisheries is actually industry. So devoted to catching, processing or selling of fish as well as shellfish or some other aquatic animals also. A large number of our population is dependent on fish, fish products and other aquatic animals such as prawn, crab, lobster, edible oyster and some other animals for food requirement. Some of the freshwater fishes, they are common and named Katla, Rohu, and some common carps. Some of the marine fishes that are eaten there also included hilsa, sardines, mackerel, then pomfrets and some other species. So, different techniques they have been applied to increase production like aquaculture and pisciculture here. Blue Revolution is implemented to increase fish production and it is named Blue Revolution. It is applied to implemented to increase the fish production. Fisheries has an important place in Indian economy. It provides income and employment to millions of fishermen and farmers, particularly in the coastal areas, coastal states. For many, it is the only source of their livelihood. In order to meet the increasing demand on fisheries, different techniques have been employed to increase production. For example, if we talk about this type of technique, that is aquaculture and pisciculture, that we have been able to increase the production of aquatic plants and animals, both freshwater and marine water. This pisciculture and aquaculture. So, pisciculture, it means it's a process of growing fish and selling it or using its products for domestic or commercial use. Fish can be grown both in salt water or fresh water. So, we can then say that this pisciculture, it deals with fishes. Aquaculture. This aquaculture process of growing any aquatic animal and selling them for commercial purpose. It involves feeding, harvesting and many other processes. The most popular ones grown under controlled environment are shrimps, crab, fish, lobster and some other. So these practices, they lead to the development and flourishing of the fishery industry, and it has brought a lot of income to the farmers in particular and the country in general. So, the Blue Revolution, this word is also useful as being implemented along the same lines as Green Revolution. Green Revolution, this deals with agriculture. You know very well about it, and is when it is related with the type of fisheries, pisciculture and aquaculture, that is deal with Blue Revolution.